The King of the Monsters fights the Lord of the Skies. Here's a look at the new Jax Pacific Godzilla King of the Monsters. This is Godzilla versus King Ghidorah. Godzilla King of the Monsters follows the heroic efforts of the Cryptozoological Agency Monarch as its members face off against a battery of God-sized monsters, including the mighty Godzilla, who collides with Mothra, Rodan, and its ultimate nemesis, the three-headed King Ghidorah. When these ancient super species, thought to be mere myths, rise again, they all vie for supremacy, leaving humanity's very existence hanging in the balance. While we get these monsters measured off, I want to send out a big thank you to the folks over at Jax Pacific that provided the samples for this review. We're going to start first with the Ultra Measuretron measuring off to the top of Godzilla. We just knocked down King Ghidorah. Godzilla stands at 3.5 inches in height, which in centimeters works out to be a figure that's 8.9 centimeters tall. King Ghidorah might be a little bit more trickier to measure off, being the wings will vary depending on how you want to display the figure. So I'm going to actually go to the very top of its highest head, putting the tape measure right there, stopping the tape measure where it's at. I can easily tell you guys that the King Ghidorah stands a little bit taller, 4.1 inches in height, which in centimeters works out once again to being 10.4 centimeters tall. Included with the two figures, you get yourself a cardboard diorama backdrop. It's fairly small, so I mean, when you are putting it, say, behind the monsters, for example, it sort of gets lost in the mix. But I do appreciate for the fact that they would include something like this. I just would have loved if it was a little bit bigger. The scene seems to be a rather destroyed, rather being an understatement, a stadium, likely where the monsters have, you know, walked through, or at the very least, Godzilla has walked through. It stands atop of this plastic peg with a little slot on the top there. Just fits into place. And like I said, you can put that displayed behind. Really, even if you want to just display it behind Godzilla, you could certainly do that. I would imagine all the two packs that we're going to be having a look at probably have their own unique diorama display featured that you can display behind the monsters. So we're going to put that right over there. Let's first have a look at Godzilla, then we'll have a look at King Ghidorah. I'm thrilled for the fact also for the longest time, we're getting ourselves a Godzilla movie that has multiple monsters in it. Even like North American released Godzilla films really haven't delved into the idea of introducing such iconic monsters. The old traditional Godzilla films of yesteryear, the Toho, I believe it was the Toho films, all had, of course, the introductions of Rodan and King Ghidorah. It's really cool, again, that we're getting like a Hollywood release. I certainly, again, can't wait for that to come out. So here we have, of course, the main man. Here's Godzilla. There's a little bit of assembly when you get this out of packaging. I don't know if I can, there we go. The tail is just a separate piece. It's simply a case of just taking the peg, lining it up to the hole. You know how this goes. It's simple preschool. Plugs into place, and in the virtue of that, it also gives you a little bit of poseability. Sometimes when you are rotating the tail does pop off, but at the very least, you can rotate the tail, and there's also secondary rotation happening at the back. The head sculpt is pretty good, again, for its size. You can see that they've even painted in the eyeball, and the pupil also has been painted in there as well. The teeth have also been done in white, and there is a very slight, what appears to be brushing, of a lighter gray color amongst the coloring of what I can only describe as almost like a very dark blue-based gray that they've given Godzilla here. The spikes have been left off, kept only to the coloring of the plastic. I don't know, looking at them, they do seem like the Godzillas may slightly vary by paint as you look at each of the packs that come with the new monster. We'll, of course, look at that and entertain the idea of doing that when we have a look at all the other three packs. We'll do some nice, fun comparisons when we get them all together. I want to kind of get all the monsters lined up and put together. So as a whole, like, really a nice, small, smaller stylized version of Godzilla, something you can just put on your desk, or ideally if kids want to play around with these, as these are certainly geared towards the kids. I think these would be also really quite fun as well if you had like little small die-cast cars. You know, the Godzilla would be a lot bigger than that, but this is certainly something that you could have a lot of fun with, building small little cityscapes out of cardboard, boxes, and little small little trinkets that you can have Godzilla again walking through that. His posability does have a head rotation. You can swivel the head around. You can also move the arms back and forth. They don't hinge outward, rather still only just swivel back and forth, and you can swivel the feet back and forth. There are no peg holes on the undersides, but rest assured, Godzilla stands perfectly fine. It's just a matter of getting the feet lined up. The tail, of course, does a lot of the supporting by keeping the figure upright as well. Moving all the way over to King Ghidorah, really super thrilled. And really, of all the packs, I really wanted to look at this one first and foremost. King Ghidorah I've always been a really big fan of in the original Godzilla films. And again, I'm just, again, super thrilled, you can probably tell it, super thrilled that we are getting like a Hollywood release featuring some of these classic monsters. Now, King Ghidorah doesn't have any assembly required when you get it out of the packaging. It pretty much what you see is what you get. There are some moving components to it, one of which being the wings. The wings can open and shut. I do find like the wings stay down well, but there's nothing really that holds the figure upright. So when you do bring the wings down, by virtue of that, you also have a figure that is a little bit more front heavy. The wings are done really quite well here. Sort of these giant dragon wings, of course. You can see all like the little wrinkles to the skin there, and the actual fingers, the extensions of the appendages that run through the, you know, again, the giant wings here. Really nicely painted here. Looks like they've dry brushed it here in almost like a dark gray color. A little bit more of that darker gray makes its appearance here in the center body section. There's the front. That's what it looks like there on the front. I do notice that when I bring the wings up, like I said, they don't always stay in their position. This one wing is a little bit looser than the other here. There you can see it just drops a little bit. It also means too, because this is such a much heavier plastic that they used for the wing, keeping again the wing upright might be a little bit more trickier. Most people will probably want to display their King Ghidorah though with wings fully spread. And I guess you could probably find like a little display stand or a little clamp point in which you could have the figure kind of wedged in between just to kind of keep it standing upright. Or many people probably will just want to hang this guy. Just put a little bit of like fishing line or something and just hang it from the top of their ceiling. You could have King Ghidorah swooping across your bedroom. Having a look at its individual heads, as it does certainly have three of them, there is some mild posability. The main third middle head, I guess if you want, does have a swivel, so you can move that back and forth. And then each of the heads seems to have a hinge joint in different places. This one has it a little bit slightly higher than the one in the middle, and then the one on the end has it about mid-neck. So it gives you a little bit of possibilities for if you want to display the heads sideways, for example, and then keep the center head looking straight forward. Head sculpts are really quite good for the size of these pieces. Even like the internal sections of the mouth, they painted in pink and even painted the teeth in white. Love again this dark color that they've washed in there as well. It's just a good starting point, really. When you get the gold color happening on the main body of Ghidorah, and then you add this dark color just to bring out some of those details, it really does look quite good. Does have the two longer tails at the back. There is a little bit of posability happening in those as well. Not really much, just enough that you can rotate these back and forth, and it does have posability back and forth on the feet. Mileage may vary again, how you can get this guy to stand upright. I've just noticed that bringing like the feet forward, for example, and trying to spread the wings up, a fairly high up, you can get Ghidorah to stand. Again, probably will end up displaying. I'm going to see if I can find a fun way to display these pieces. Maybe I'll have Ghidorah hanging up, and then I'll have Godzilla kind of, you know, walking on the surface around my desk area there as well. I just kind of wish that the wings, this one wing, wasn't as loose as it was. That will vary, of course, as you get one figure to the other. I could probably just put something in there. It looks like it's just been pegged into place, so I could probably put a little bit of floor polish or something in there just to stiffen up the wings. It's just, it just bound to happen, really, because the wings are so large and they are made of a heavier plastic that they do drop forward like that. They really do stop at exactly where you would want Ghidorah's wings to stop. It's just, again, a case of getting it to stand upright. So I'll maybe see if I can find a display stand kicking around, because I certainly would want to have these ones displayed on my desk. Just fantastic looking pieces. They're small, and that's the beauty of them as well. The biggest, like I said, the hassle, if anything, not that it would necessarily be a hassle, is just to get Ghidorah's wings to stay upright and the figure not to topple forward. It is a good time to be a fan of Godzilla, with the upcoming release of Godzilla King of the Monsters and new merchandise hitting toy store shelves. Like I said, there's going to be a lot of Godzilla to be had. The folks over at Jack's Pacific have a whole lineup of new Godzilla pieces that you can pick up starting April 1st, 2019. All of these pieces that we're going to be looking at in these reviews are going to be available in Walmart starting April 1st, 2019. To check out some other cool stuff that Jack's Pacific has lined up, I'll put the link down below to their website. Like I said, we're going to be having a look at a whole bunch of new Godzilla King of the Monsters toys, so hopefully you guys will stay tuned to this channel. Again, a big thank you to Jack's Pacific for providing the pieces that we're going to be looking at in the upcoming reviews. Today, once again, we were having a look at the new Jack's Godzilla King of the Monsters, and this was Godzilla versus King Ghidorah. Make sure as well, my friends, my colleagues of the interweb, you hit that little subscribe button down below, because like I said, for fans of Godzilla, there's going to be a whole lot of Godzilla stuff coming onto this channel soon. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys next time.